and tools as well. You know, and teammates are not as bonding, but I think they don't get it.
So how do you withdraw now? How do you extract yourself without somebody somehow subtly, implicitly saying, Bernie, the game's not over till I say it's over? But framing it that way makes Bernie sound like a victim here. Which maybe in some sense he is, but also he hasn't come up with this scheme. Like, the top four is eventually come up with this scheme. Yeah, Bernie is clearly the author of this Ponzi scheme, and there's no con man more talented than Bernie. But let's face it, he was favored by circumstance, by luck. But Bernie is an incredibly skillful and talented liar. No other way to put it. At the same time, Bernie could not have done this without the implicit cooperation of a number of institutions and investors. One of the biggest was the Spanish bank, Banco Santander, whose control of a company called Optimal Investment Service. Now, many of their clients were small-time investors, going to the United States. Banks are supposed to make sure that the funds they sell to their customers are stable and safe. And that's where Rajiv Jaitley comes in. I was, in effect, the hustle factor. Rajiv was hired by Optimal to do what's called due diligence on Bernie's fund, but he immediately goes pushback. Rajiv wanted to put the whole thing on his but says his boss didn't want to make waves.
I think he was concerned that I would spoil the relationship.
A relationship that was making the bank a commission on every dollar delivered to Bernie. Rajiv met with Bernie in February of 2006, and one of the things he wanted to do was see a trade from beginning to end.
And he could see how it's entered the system, how it might appear on statements, different brokers, and so on. I was just told that that is something that happened, I should write it.
Rajiv left the meeting with Bernie with, well, no answers. He went back to his office to write his report, but didn't feel he had enough information, so he asked one of his colleagues to verify the trades.
When I then ran out to sort of see how it was going, he said, no, we haven't done that. So he said, no, Rajiv, you know, we all know you're a difficult guy. You know, we have to calm you down at the official points, so we agreed to it. But yeah, there's really no need to do all of this. We understand the investment strategy. You know, it doesn't need this.
But he said, type of report, but it wasn't wrong, and it wasn't what his boss was looking for. They ordered a new image for
that idea. The report, at its very beginning, says that their view was made up of a well-run official organization, to which I'm responsible on a basis.
This was a G's last straw. He quit working for Optimal.
The reason I resigned was because I felt that Optimal weren't serious about risk, and so I decided to stop working with
him. But G's boss was eventually prosecuted for mismanaging his client's money. He was found not guilty. The other people whose job it was to uncover scams like Bernie's were the regulators in New York. That means Bernie was under examination or investigation for 30 years. But here was the amazing dynamics of that situation. Bernie is considered a lion of Wall Street. They send in the Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC, the body that is supposed to regulate and watchdog people like Bernie. They send in investigators, examiners, but they are extremely junior. They're young, they're recently out of school. They've never investigated a Ponzi scheme before. After the fraud was exposed, the SEC wanted to know why people never caught on. So it conducted an internal investigation. It was run by the accountants.
I was only the second inspector general in the history of the SEC. Previous inspector general had been there for 18 years.
They issued more than 100 interviews over the course of 7 months. He was talking to Bernie, he told him about one encounter with the SEC examiner.
Sort of acting like a tough guy, and, you know, yeah, he leaned back with his hands behind his head, like Lieutenant Columbo, and, you know, asking tough questions. He wore an SEC jacket with the word enforcement emblazed across the back. Now, he wasn't in enforcement. Enforcement is the entity that essentially sues people. He was an examiner. And that he started acting like a jerk and was acting really tough and like a big shot. Yet Madoff pointed out that while he started acting like a blowhard, he made off words, he never really asked any tough questions. So it was all a show. Madoff was able to see through it really quickly, but
there were a couple times when examiners came close to exposing Bernie's fraud.
I mean, it's actually not that difficult to uncover plans if you're the federal government. There are ways that you can go and see where trades are clear.
When investors are bought and sold, money goes to the buyer and sell. Clearly, the deposits with two accounts are updated to reflect the transaction. The buyer's account shrinks and sellers goes up. This proves that the money is actually changing hands. Sounds pretty basic, right? That's what the depository trust company is for. This is called the DTC. Basically, it's where the money sits when the trades get cleared, when the trades get done. So there should be tons of money in Bernie's account.
If the allegation is the guy isn't trading, then you can go to this place and you can see where he's trading.
Yes, where are the securities? For the client, then I think that's a depository trust. That's Bernie, from a deposition taken from behind prison walls. So they just wanted to verify that Bernie's transactions were real. So they asked
him, do you have an account at DTC? He said, yes, they asked me the account number. 646,
that's my account number.
He gave me the account number.
And when I left that meeting, I think that's it. They got me.
He thought Monday morning, he'd be going to jail.
I lied to them and said they were at the depository, and I think for sure they're going to call the depository on Monday morning. That's why not the security was there. Somebody at the SEC does call the DTC and asks about Bernie's account, but all that person asks is, does Bernie have an account? Once he gets the yes, the person moves on. Now, the next question they should ask is, how much money is in that account? Well, Bernie should have had billions of dollars in that account, and he had maybe a few million, tens of millions. The Ponzi scheme would have gone down, it would have been exposed, had they asked that one further question. But these guys are junior, they're inexperienced, and they're intimidated. They're intimidated by Bernie, and they're intimidated, it seems, by the functioning of the financial system. They just don't know about the DTC. The SEC missed a chance. And it wasn't just the SEC. There were private auditors sniffing around to find out how Bernie was making money. The returns were impressive, and they wanted to know more.
I can't function in what it happened to me, but I want to use that to help others. But then to have, like I said, I feel that I have. If it's such a news documentary, that's the latest news Sunday on all things considered. Okay, here it is.
After 20 minutes, from the Center for Investigative Reporting at Pearlex, this is revealed on our website. Bernie made off with a criminal mastermind. We've heard how he pulled off the Ponzi scheme for decades, who made the people work for him, regulators, and investors. But no one crashed down with a financial crisis of 2008. People were dead. They wanted their investment back. But the money was gone.
Don't worry, something never happened to us. Everything that we worked for.
You sound ready? This can't be real. Bernie was taking almost 18...